Hello everyone, in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to make this material cutoff effect like this. So you can cut this mesh using a spear, so you can change the color of it to whatever you like, and also the hardness and the power. Then you can boost the emissive color, and also if I go to the material, this is the material function we are going to create today. It looks a bit complicated, but it is really easy. Now if I go here and check this, so we can use a custom position with this and apply. Wait for it to compile. Now if I change the radius, it will cut the mesh using this position as the center. So if I move it here and bring the radius back to normal and start to cut it, it will go to the center like that. And also this material can be, material function can be used with any material. So if I go to the grass material and connect this to the emissive color and connect this to the opacity mask, so in order to get the opacity mask you need to go to blend mode and change this to masked. Now if I click apply and wait for it to compile, now by reducing the radius I can cut this landscape off like that, and I can change the center with this. So now it will cut off from there like that. So to create this material function, right click, then go to materials and textures, then go to material function, then I will name this cutoff and open it up. So I will stop previewing this so we don't see this error. So we need an emissive color output and an opacity output. So right click and type in output, function output. Then I will change the first one to emissive and the second one to opacity. Now we will get a spear mask and we will get a function input, input function. Then connect this to A and duplicate this and connect this to B. So with a spear mask, this will create a spear around this point. So if we give an axial position here as a default value and world position here, this will draw a spear making the axial position as a center and with the radius that we will specify. So for the radius we will get a function input, so drag from radius and type in function input, so we get a scalar function input. And also for the hardness, drag from here and type in function input. So now we will rename this. So the first one should be position A and the second one will be position B. So for this we will set a sort priority of 1. So if we have a sort priority of 0, it will be the first input in the material function, this one, and if you have a sort priority of 1, it will be the second input, and so on. So here this will be 1 and this will be 2 and this will be 3. So the name of this input function is radius. And this one should be hardness. So So now we will power this. So this is just to get some extra control. This is just doing what this hardness is doing. So I'll just bring it here. And drag from here and type in function input. And I will name this power. Then it will have a solve priority of 4. Now we will get the emissive output from here. So for that, get a lerp node by pressing and holding L and clicking, and connect this to the alpha and connect this to the emissive output. So here, anything within the radius of this sphere will have a value of 1 from here, and anything outside will have a value of 0, and the hardness will kind of feather the fall off. So there will be a light gradient from the transition from 0 to 1. So here, if the material is inside the sphere, it will give a value of 1. So anything inside the sphere, we don't really need to give an emissive color. So we will get a black color and connect this here. Anything that doesn't have a value of 1 but have a value between 0 and 1, we will give a color, so that will create the fringes. So I will just drag from here and type in function input and change this to fringe color, and this will have a priority of 5. Now we will boost this value by getting a multiply node, connect this here and get a function input and change the priority to 6, I think. Yeah, 6. Then change the name to boost. So that's all we need to do here. Connect this to the emissive color, and for the alpha we can just connect this here. Now if you need to use a custom position other than the pivot position of the actor, then we can get a function input 3, function input 3 vector. Then we will get a switch, static switch, then connect true here, false to here, and this will be the custom position. And connect this to true and drag from here and type in function or input, function input. This will be a static bool, and connect this to B. So if we give a value of true to this, then we can use the custom position, and if the value of this is false, then the actor position will be used for the B input. So now I will change the name to custom position, and this is the use custom position. Then the sort priority is okay, so this one will be 7 and this one will be 8. So that's all we need to do here. Then click apply and save. So now we will create our material. So right click material, cutoff underscore mat, then open it up, then bring the material function in like that, just drag and drop. Then we will give a base color to this, so I will give a blue color. Then I will change the blend mode to masked. So we get the opacity mask. So now connect the opacity mask here and connect the MC color here. And the position A, we will give world position. And for position B, we will give actor position. And for the radius, we will get a scalar parameter. Press S and click. And connect this here and change this to radius. And for the hardness, we will get a new scalar parameter. Now connect this to hardness. I will rename this hardness. Now for power, we will get another scalar parameter and connect this to power. Name this power. And the fringe color, we will get a vector parameter. So press V and hold and connect this to the fringe color and change this to color. And for the boost, we will create a scalar parameter again and connect this to boost. Name this boost. And for the custom position, use custom position, we will get a bool, static bool parameter, and I will name this use custom position. So there is some error. Let me check the material function. So oh, this is scalar. We need to change this to vector 3 and click apply. Okay, that fixed it. Now for the custom position, we need to create a collection parameter. So go to the content browser, right click, materials and textures, material collection parameters. I will name this cutoff collection or cut collection and open it up. We will add a vector parameter called position. Then we can get that here. So right click and type in collection parameters and change this to cutoff. It is already added. So change the parameter name to position and connect this here. Now click apply and save. Now go to the content browser. We will create a material instance from that and open that up. Then check all of this and change this to a cube, and I will give a red color and I will give boost a color, boost a value of 30, and hardness I will give a value of 0.5, and power I will give a value of 1 for now. So now our cube has disappeared, and if I increase the radius, you can see it coming up. So there is some issues. Yeah, the issue was the power. So now we can adjust the power like that. So you can control the size of the fringe like that, and you can change the color here, like an yellowish color. Then you can control the radius like this, and you can work with the cylinder or any other custom mesh. So if I get a custom mesh from here, from probes, I will get this rock, then click this. So now to use the custom position, we need to create an actor like the one I created here. So for that, right click and actor, right click and blueprint class, then actor. Now I will name this position, then open it up, then go to construction script, then I will drag from here and type in set collection or set vector parameter value, then change this to cut collection, and we will change the parameter name to position. Now we will drag from here and get world location and connect this to the parameter value and compile and save. Then bring that into the world. So now I will apply this material here to the actor. Now if I reduce the radius, you can see that he is being cut off like that. And if I check use custom position and check this, let it compile. Now I can use this position as a center, so it will be cut off from there like that. Or if I bring it here, like this. I'll just change the scale a bit so that it is easy to see. So 5, 5, and 5. Now if I change the radius, so you can place it anywhere and make it cut off from there like that. So when I started this tutorial, I have actually placed all the controls in the position actor. So I have created a scalar parameter and a vector parameter for all these controls, so I could change it from the actor itself. So the actor looks like this. So I have created a variable and exposed it, and then I can change this value in the editor itself. So if I change that, see, I don't really have to change the material instance for that. I can change all of that with the actor. So I think that's it for the tutorial. If you like my tutorial, leave a like and subscribe. And if you want to support my channel, you can check out my Patreon. So thanks for watching. See you next time.